My name is Toqir Ahmed Qasmi and I am Hafiz and Qari Alhamdulillah. I completed my Fazila course from Darul Uloom Deoband in 2002. Then I done Takmil-e-Adab Arabi, that is Arabic literature course from the same university, Darul Uloom Deoband. Then I went to Mumbai to learn English language and literature from Markazul Maarif Education and Research Center. So I completed my diploma of English language of 2 years there. Then I was selected as a trainee over there in Markazul Maarif Education and Research Center. Then I came to Madrasa Khadimul Ulum Baghwali and I studied Arabic and English subjects there for 2 years. Then again I was called to Mumbai as an English teacher in Markazul Maarif Education and Research Center. I taught there for 4 years nearly. Last year I came to Darul Uloom Deoband and I joined the English department of Darul Uloom Deoband. And I have been teaching here English for the last almost 10 months. Actually, Deoband established Department of English Language and Literature because Deoband want its products to present Islam in the people who know English language. Also, there are so many misconceptions and misunderstandings about Islam. So we want our products to remove them about Islam. Also, there are so many articles against Islam and Muslims that if we don't know English language, we cannot understand them properly. And unless or until we understand them, we cannot make others, we cannot clear our ideas. So we want our message of Islam to spread all over the world. That's why we are teaching our products English language.
Okay. Then English is not the only language. In fact, there are other languages as well. Why don't you teach them as well? Other languages like French, like Japanese, like, you know, Chinese, like Spanish.
Yeah.
The other day you were telling me a Spanish journalist was here.
Yeah.
So why, if the idea is that of propagation of Islam or trying to remove the misconceptions prevalent across the world, you know, in all the spheres, including media, then why don't you teach other languages as well?
Yeah, actually, you know, English is an international language. It is one of the most spoken languages in the world. Yeah, if you know English language, you won't feel difficult.
No, that's true. Yeah. That's true.
Yeah.
But there are still people who don't speak English. They speak Spanish.
Yeah, but most of them understand English, though they don't speak. But actually, you cannot have everything in one jamia or university.
Okay.
So we have started.
Or you can say that probably when Deoband will feel the importance of Spanish.
Yeah, inshallah, definitely it will do.
After 10 years from now, it will establish Spanish language as well. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So
actually, it is easier to get English teachers. It's a little bit difficult also.
Okay, then that's very interesting.
Yeah.
I mean, why it's difficult? Why do you think it's difficult for Deoband to find English language teachers? There are so many Muslim students across the country who know English. Why don't you hire them?
Actually, I'm talking about an alim.
Okay.
That there are very few alim who know English language very well. But still there are people, ulama who know English language. But as far as Spain and Japanese language go, you would hardly find any.
I mean, as far as that thing is concerned, I think if you start that department here, teach the Deoband students here, and they'll establish an apartment. A department. First of all, as far as Spanish is concerned, when it comes to you were talking about that there are not many ulemas who know English. And you know who are expert of English in the country. There are many. I mean, I'm surprised that you're saying that there are not many ulemas.
Mm-hmm.
There are many. Just that they're not. All of them might not be from Deoband.
Yeah.
So is it? Do you? Does Deoband employ only people from Deoband?
In Darul Uloom Deoband.
Yes.
Yes, in Darul Uloom Deoband. Generally, we hire the people who are a product of Darul Uloom Deoband.
Okay, that's not fair, some say. Some might say that's not fair.
Actually, every institution has a policy. There are some rules we stand by.
Okay. So you are saying that Deoband has this official or unofficial policy of hiring only those people who have studied from Deoband.
Yeah, this is the one of the principles of Darul-Uloom Deoband.
Official or unofficial?
I'm not sure.
Okay. What about this idea? Like, how many students are there in Department of English? In your class?
In my class, almost for 20 students get education of English language.
Okay, so tell us how does Department of English works in Deoband? Does every student has to opt English as a language, or it's optional, or it's compulsory? At what stage it's optional? At what stage it's compulsory?
No, actually, when Darul-Uloom Deoband students complete their graduation course from Darul-Uloom Deoband, so if they are interested to learn English language.
Oh, sorry to interrupt you. What do you mean by graduation course? Which course?
Graduation means Alimiyat course, Fazila course.
Okay, so
when they complete it and they are interested to learn English language and their marks are above 76%, then they are free or they are allowed to submit their applications in the English department. And on the this year, I think there were above almost 50 applications from the students, but only 18 students were selected on their merit basis.
Okay. So you are saying that after graduation, yeah, after Fazilat,
yeah,
if students are given an option, mm-hmm, if they are interested,
yeah,
and if their marks is beyond 76%,
yeah,
they can opt for English.
Yeah, yeah.
So at present, how many students? Just 26 students are there who want to learn English.
Yes.
That's all. How many students are there in Deoband?
There are almost 4,000 students.
4,000, just 26 and 4,000 students.
Yeah.
Who want to learn English?
Yeah. No, as earlier I said that a lot of students want, but some of them don't have 76% marks. There are.
That's I understand that, but don't you think it's unfair to put a cap of 76% marks to learn English?
Actually, we want our talented students to learn English language.
No, but you are saying that 76% marks in which subjects?
In their Islamic subjects, right, like fiqh,
okay,
hadith, and
okay,
other subjects.
So you want only those people who are very good in Islamiyat,
yeah,
to learn English?
Yeah.
You don't want others to learn English?
No, actually we want them to, our mission is to spread Islam. And if the students are intelligent, they can do it.
Okay. So,
yeah.
But don't you think that putting a cap of 76% marks, I mean, only those students who get 76% marks can learn English, is a bit of unfair?
Because
English, yeah, English is a language. It's a skill. I mean,
yeah,
it empowers people.
Actually, there are so many departments of specialization here. Diploma in Arabic language and literature, specialization in Hadith, Iftah course, the students who learn Iftah and after 1 year they become Mufti. There are so many departments.
Mm-hmm.
And only every year almost 1,000 students graduate from Darul-Uloom Deoband.
1,000.
Yeah, from them we just have 20 students, and it is not only Darul-Uloom Deoband, but there are so many madaris now who are running such kind of institutions. Markaz al-Maarif is one of them in Mumbai. In Kandla also there runs one department of this. In Muzaffarabad also, in Delhi also, in Ankleshwar, even in Bangalore. So there are so many departments of English language now. But here in Darul-Uloom Deoband, we have just almost 20 students.
Okay, so, I mean, you don't think that out of 4,000 students, just 26 students learn English is a bit of...
No, some students just learn English by their interest. They just go somewhere else to learn English. But
okay,
there are so many students now who know English language.
Tell me something about... Department of English, how many teachers are there in this department?
There are two teachers in English department.
Okay.
And we teach them textbooks from the very beginning up to the standards of BA. From the classical literature, I try to teach some selected sonnets of Shakespeare. and we teach them translation from Urdu to English and vice versa, from Arabic to English and vice versa. We teach them Rand Martin's ten standards grammar book. Also, we have one subject, Dawah studies. So we just teach them a few selected verses of the glorious Quran with English translation, and some common questions from non-Muslims about Islam and their responses in English language, and Dawah techniques.